What's going on, guys? It's BlackHawk6589 here. Just out hiking today. I'm just trying to be quiet because I saw there's another person out hunting. It's October 1st, which means Halloween's almost right around the corner. So, about Grand River Wildlife Area, just kind of hiking around. And at mosquito. And there, I was looking on the maps because ODNR just changed all their website and stuff. And I think they changed the maps. I think they updated the maps. And I'm gonna go out hiking. If you go north, east, there's a huge pond. So I've never been out that side, but out the northwest side. So we're gonna go hike here. It just rained yesterday and the day before, so it's kind of a little mucky right now. We're going to keep going. Apparently all the mosquitoes are still out. It's a little chilly today. It's upper 50s. Low 60s. Still a beautiful day out there. Bugs are out still, which they don't bother me. Get used to them. Get used to them where you put bug spray on, so try not to make any noise. So my loadout today, good old bear spray, single action army, and on this side, a camera, and my Mora. These mosquitoes are everywhere. And my Mora. Whatever model this is. I forgot what model it was. The stainless steel version. So. Yeah, so we're going to keep on going hiking and might put on some bug spray because these mosquitoes are already hungry. So let's keep marching. So, almost tripped. Good thing I brought my buck boots. I went really far west. I actually haven't been this far west. I'm trying not to cross the river. That felt weird. I'm trying not to cross the river because the lake, or the pond, oh crap. Crap. So the pond can actually be accessed either side, so. Wow, I'm really surprised on these boots. I was gonna get soaking wet. Like that. Oh. Knew that was gonna happen. Thank God for buck boots. I think I'd fall in. It's like slippery. Oh. scared the crap out of me. I almost fell backwards. And that's why you wear old clothing. Okay, well, I catch my breath. Good thing I have it. This is a waterproof camera, so. Actually, not that dirty. I thought it'd get soaking wet, but. And that's why you wear water resistant clothing. And I'll update you guys when I get back up. So I've noticed a lot of people have been hiking lately, and huge issue, but some tips I want to give to the new hikers out there is. Okay, so. Unless the park specifically says do not wander off the trail, you could kind of wander off the trail, so. National forests, state forests, and at least in Ohio they have wildlife areas, which are like hunting areas, all kind of let you go off the trails. Wildlife areas you have to because there's no trails. So those areas you're pretty much fine to go off trails. Parks are iffy. I know I heard some of the ones out west make you stay on the trails. And then some here, they kind of encourage you to stay on the trails. It's weird. So just whatever the park rules say. Which again, parks are a little bit different than forests and wildlife areas. Now the big thing that I've seen, and it really angers me, but annoys me, is the nature preserves, which are on their own class of themselves. They are, literally, you're supposed to be on the trail only. And all it is to preserve the wildlife there, or the nature and stuff. So like any nature preserves, I don't know what the federal nature preserves are, Mr. Nature sanctuaries and stuff. Make sure you stay on the trail and follow the rules, because they could fine the crap out of you for stepping off the trail. Tip that's actually, still to this day, I still kind of get tripped up on it. Just bring two compasses. And you're going to say, well, I just bring one good one. Why do I need two? So, when you're out hiking and you get lost. Okay, so I'm going to pull up my map. Pull out your compass. And obviously, let's say you kneel on the trail or something, you know. And, you're looking at the map and, no, I'm going east, I'm not going this way, I'm not going north. The trail's this way. Well, there's a thing of self-doubt, where you doubt that the compass is right. And you're like, oh, I know for a fact I'm going east, I'm not going north, my compass is off. My compass is off by like 10 degrees. You know, it's gotta be off. So, in your mind, because you're lost, you're confused, you're turning around, you think that you really are, you know, going north, but let's say you're actually going east. Because you don't believe your compass, you know. So if you carry two compasses, put them down, don't put them side by side. Never put them side by side, then you're really gonna be lost. So you take two compasses, so you put one says north, one says north. Okay, so now you can't really doubt yourself. Now you can say, well, there's no way that two compasses can be off, you know. That hurt, turkey. So that's the biggest tip. I was out hiking with my buddy. We were at Cuyahoga National Park, and we were on the trailhead, and I brought my compass, and I know it was a little bit off, but it wasn't that far off. It was only maybe like 2 or 3 degrees, which, so we're walking, and we're looking at the map, and we're like, okay, well, we know for a fact we took this trail. We followed it, it branched off to somewhere else, and we're like, okay, we're lost. So I pulled my compass, and I was like, no, I was like, we're going this direction. I said, I don't know how the compass is off, da-da-da-da. So at the trip, we didn't follow the compass at all. Well, we found out. And the compass was right, and the trail we took was something different, so. So you might be wondering, oh my god, where are you at? You're probably lost. Well, no, because, like I said, I hike a lot in this area. So I kind of know my way. Over here, there's actually some fallen leaves. And then a little bit up there is the little, not river, but creek or whatever you want to call it, stream. And I know behind me is the road. And you could tell by that is I keep walking with the stream to my left shoulder and the roadway almost to my right shoulder. And you can also do that by sound, too. So I know I could hear traffic. Which means there's a road somewhere over there. I can hear the water flowing that way. So that's a good tip for new people hiking in like off-trail settings or even new hunters and stuff too. Imagine getting stuck in that. That is just growth upon growth upon growth of briars. So, I don't know if this is the pond. Creepy tree sound. I don't know if this is the pond. I think it is. Because it kind of fell in the water river thing that way, but I don't know if this is just a drop off or the pond, but or another tributary, whatever. But this kind of looks like it. This place reeks. It stinks so freaking bad over here. Imagine having like an aquarium and it hasn't been changed in 2 months, where it's like that brownish, brackish water. It's exactly what this smells like. Pretty rough. So I'm just gonna start heading back. So I'm back over here, which is kind of close to the entrance. So a little update, as soon as I stopped the camera, right up there, I heard a big, which I thought it was a deer for a second, and then I look at it, it's a huge freaking owl. I don't know if it was a great horned owl, whatever, a tree owl, whatever, but freaking flew so low, flew like about this low into the woods over there. That's why you gotta go in these wildlife areas, because you see stuff that you would never see on the trail.